Hey guys and gals, and welcome to the very first Let's Relax with RimWorld. So, let's get started and take a look at the mods that we've got installed. Now, there are three main mods that I'm going to be using throughout this playthrough. The main one, which is an umbrella for many other small mods that come under it, is the tech tree minimi. So, with that, there's a whole new tech tree with a whole new string of upgrades that you can do. It's a lot more of a slow progression at the start. You don't start off with a lot of high technology. The idea is that you crash landed on the planet and you only have what you have with you to build and try and survive. So it makes things a little bit more difficult starting off, and it makes things like wood much more valuable to you. Having a look at some of the others, there's EDB. So EDB is both the interface and a prepare carefully mod. So the interface mod essentially adds a lot of things that aren't in the game at the moment, but I'm pretty sure they'll be there eventually. So it's just like status bars at the top. It just makes keeping track of your colonists a lot easier than it is in the vanilla game. Now, prepare carefully is going to help us out a little bit here because that allows us to customize our colonists, as you'll see in a little bit. And so I'll explain that when we go through to the next section. But next up for us is going to be creating a new world. So to do that, we're just going to go here. We're going to go for the largest possible, so let's go for 400 by 300, and for a seed, let's just try Rycon. So that's going to sit there and generate, and there we go. So a Lua Septimus. Oh well, that kind of works with Leon. So we've got a big world here. You can see that a lot of the northern region is frozen, and we've got some more deserts and shrubland down the bottom here, but primarily it's mostly tropical rainforest and just this normal temperate forest, that's what it's called. So we're going to save that and finish. Next thing for us to do is to go to the new colony. Now, there's three different AI storytellers in this. Cassandra Classic is, well, essentially it builds a story over time, so things aren't as hard when you start off, but eventually as the game develops, it's going to become a lot tougher. Phoebe Base Builder is essentially for building bases. So it's almost like creative mode on Minecraft, where you're not going to get attacked by things, and it's more about building than survival. And finally, Randy Random is random. I think this is probably the most realistic, because obviously, you know, it's life isn't a linear story. Things happen out of order all the time. Except we're storytellers here, so we're probably going to go with Cassandra Classic, because I like that. The building up from the bottom and kind of making our way up to more difficult challenges. So we're going to go with challenge, which means that whenever anything bad does happen, it's going to be 100% as large. So it's just like the flat rate. Anything beneath that, it's going to be easier each time. And same thing when we're looking at the two final challenge difficulties. They're a lot harder, so it goes up to 130 and then finally 160. Yeah, so that just means that essentially if there were guys coming to attack you, there'd be more of them. There'd be, you know, more well-armed. So we're just going to go right in the middle and just sit with challenge. Now you can see I've got two worlds here, but this is the one that I've created now. I'm actually just going to delete that old world because we're not going to need that. So we'll select that. Okay, so you can see we've got quite a lot of space here to go with, and I kind of would almost like the idea of going for random. You know, because we're crash landing on a planet. I think selecting a landing site's a little bit strange, but I suppose we might have some control over these pods as they're coming down. So you can see we've got a few different things that we can look at here, elevation, rainfall. But we're just going to chuck it on full for now. It seems like this is probably the most kind of rainy region down here in the tropical rainforest, I think it is. Rain's good. We're going to get a lot more growth and stuff like that way. I don't know how much of that is actually simulated in the game at the moment, but I kind of almost like being close to the coast as well, so I'm just going to have a look and see what we got around here. It'd be nice to get a mountainous region as well. Mountains make it a little bit easier to defend because it's more about mining at the start of the game then, because you can kind of mine into the mountains and build your base that way rather than putting up walls, but we'll just see what we've got available to us. But I think we're probably going to go up with this position here. So it's a pretty nice temperature there. It's a tropical rainforest. It's mountains. Decent amount of rainfall. Could be too much, but we'll have to see. So we're going to select that as our site. Okay, so now you can see that we've got three colonists to work with, and this is what it usually looks like in the vanilla game, but down here we've got this extra button, prepare carefully, and that's what that EDB mod adds for us. So we're going to click on that. Now you can see that we can change the way that our colonists look, and we can even change their skills and their abilities here, but you have a limit to that. You know, you've got these points over here in the corner, and that's very similar to Dwarf Fortress's kind of embarking, where you have points and you kind of need to split them between your colonists and then eventually the items that you'll be bringing with you. I think you can actually turn the points off as well, so you can just go absolutely crazy and chuck in as many points as you want, but we're still looking for a bit of a challenge, so we're not going to be doing that. But if I go load preset and we hit this one here, boom, there are three very familiar names up here. So up first we've got Logan, and as you can see for his last name, it's not there, so we've just chucked six there for now. So Logan's 27 here, and for the backstory and the traits, I've tried to get things that I think match the characters as, you know, as best as you can within a game that's completely different from where they're actually from. So for Logan, we've got Apocalypse Child for him and Scout, because I think those two work quite well towards who Logan is and I think who we will be in this game as well. So he's also a careful shooter and an optimist. He's incapable of intellectual actions, so that's mostly research. But that's going to be okay, because we're going to leave our research up to Nick, I believe. If we have a look through Logan's skills here, we can see that he is got a passion for construction. So he's not too great at it, but he'll get better at it over time. But he's also good at growing. But his main skills lie in shooting. So Logan's essentially going to be our sheriff. He's really good at shooting people, but then he's also good at social as well, so he's good at talking people down, and he'll also be good at getting people to join us. At the same time, his cooking is quite high as well, because he can't be a sheriff all the time. We need him to do things, so he needs to pull his own weight when he's not going around shooting people and locking them up. So he's going to be our cook and our grower whenever he's not taking care of the place. Okay, so if we move along to Mr. Leonidas Aventus. So we've got Leon here. He was a medieval squire in his childhood, and we've got military commissar for his adulthood. So they're the two that I found that kind of fit him best, but you can also see down here under traits we've got bloodlust. So Leon gets a rush from hurting people and never minds the sight of blood or death. So that's kind of taking on his more beastly aspects that he has hidden away, so I thought it'd be a good trait for him to have. He's also incapable of cooking or plant work, so that means chopping down trees and chopping other plants, but also being unable to cook is going to be, well, I mean, it's give and take here. We can't have all positives, so some of these characters are going to have things missing that the others won't. But looking under here, he's got a really high construction skill. So he's going to be really good when it comes to building walls and other things like that. And he's also pretty good at crafting. Now, he's not our best crafter. Our best crafter is Nick, because, you know, all the walls and shelves and things that Nick builds in Project Zomboid. He's definitely the best crafter of the lot. But still, Leon's not too bad himself. But if you look here, he's really good when it comes towards his melee. So he's not as good at shooting, as we kind of know from Skyrim. You give the man a bow and arrow and he's not really too good with it. But he can, you know, even if he's not so great with it. But melee, that's where he holds his own. So with that, if anyone does get inside our base, or, you know, if someone gets into close quarters, that's when Leon's going to really be able to hold his own. But into everything else, we can see here, he can't cook, he can't grow, so he's going to be more our hauler and our tough guy. So he's going to do a lot of the hard work, like mining and the construction work. So at the start, with this being mountains, if we do end up going into the mountains, he's pretty much going to be like the main builder, because he's going to be carving out a space for us to live and survive in. Finally, we have Mr. Nicholas Miller. So he's the youngest out of the lot. I forgot to mention Leon's age, there was 33. So Nick is a dreamer and an engineer. So the engineer is kind of more towards where he's going in the Project Zomboid series, because of all the construction work he's been working on. So you can see he's got a passion for construction. And his crafting is really high as well. We do have him with a high medicine skill. Out of all of them, I think Logan would probably have the best skills when it comes towards medicine, but just in terms of how the game works, I kind of had to have that go towards Nick's character. And I think, well, I mean, he does do a little bit of medical work in Project Zomboid, so who knows, there could be more of that in the future there as well. But he's also a researcher, so he's kind of going to be our brains out of the three. So he's going to be the guy who discovers new things for us and then puts them together when he's crafting them. So That's going to be really handy. But he can also grow. He's not too great at it. And he can also cook, which he's also not too great at. But he'll be able to pick up any slack, say, if Logan isn't able to. So I think that about sums up our colonists. So what we're going to do next is hit next. And you can see that we have all these different resources here. So we've got resources, food, weapons, apparel. With this, you can pretty much select everything and anything that you want to go with you. Now, it would be really cool to get some of these things, but they're quite expensive. Now, we could probably get rid of some of these other things here, but I kind of like the idea of just going with the standard start, because, you know, I think if they were in a rush to get off the ship, they really wouldn't have much time to pack anything at all, and I kind of think that these are like the survival items that would have been in their pods as they came crashing down. So, I think that's going to about do it. So what we're going to do is here, we're just going to save the preset one more time, and we're going to hit start and get into it. So, I'll see you guys in game. Alright, here we go. The three of you awake in your in your crypto sleep sarcophagi, to the sound of ripping metal and sirens. You barely get to the escape pods before the ship is torn apart. Sometime later, you land on this unknown RimWorld. As pieces of shredded starship fall around you, you start making your plans to survive. Alright. So here's the first thing that's different from when you usually start the game. You've got this tech tree minimi research time come up here. So we've got either a fast research time or an average. We're just going to go with fast because it's the default time. So that's what the time was originally in the game. So we're going to select that. Alright, so we're going to pause the game for a moment just so we can have a look over a few things. First of all, let's have a look and see exactly where we are. So this is a tropical rainforest. This is kind of like marshy swamplands and the rest, but there are a lot of mountains here, as you can see, and there's a massive space here on the side for us that we could work with. I mean, there's a lot of room to expand into this hill here. And you can see that these are these squares, and those are ruins of past civilizations that have been on this planet before us. They're made out of stone, so we can actually deconstruct those, and we can use those stone blocks before we can actually make stone. So they can be quite handy, although yeah, there's one here, so we might actually be able to use that to build like an outer defense for us. This stuff here is metal, so that's going to be quite useful for us in the future, and it seems like there's a bit of it around. We'll have a bit of a search later on. But we'll be able to mine through that and get that, and that's going to be quite helpful later on in the game. But unfortunately at this stage we can't do much with it. See, we've got these wood logs, and wood's pretty much all that we're going to be able to use for the first, probably the first episode or two. But the first thing we're going to want to do here is grab these pods here and hit deconstruct. So they're going to wander on over there and pretty much tear them apart. So that means anything that we can get from them, we'll be able to get. Ideally, if we start somewhere near all of these things that crashed it with us, it's going to be quite good. Otherwise, we'll keep on like dragging them off. So I'm kind of thinking this isn't too bad for like a basic kind of living quarters, especially because we've already got this room here. So what we might do is just mine away a little bit of that hill there and then build into here. Now we've got tons of room to expand here, but I kind of like the idea of building into here first, because then we can use it as an outpost later in the game once we've kind of moved past it. So first things first, we're going to try and find our items and give them to each person. So Logan's going to be using this Leon field, so we're going to get him to equip that. Leon, for now, he's going to have to use a pistol before we can get him something to smash people over the head with. Nick is going to be using a pistol as well, so we just need to track down that other one. So if we just double-click, all right, it's over there. So we'll equip that. Now, everything else here, we've got food and we've got some medical supplies. They're going to run out pretty quick. So we're going to go like this, double-click on them. There's some more up there as well, and hit F, and that's going to make them unforbidden, or just make them not forbidden. Same thing with the medicine as well. So we've only got 3 packs of medicine. There could be more scattered throughout the map, as you'll probably see there. Here we go, there's some food packs up here. So they have supplies that have kind of crashed down with us and have spread over a different area. We can grab those, but I'm probably going to leave them till a little bit later on, just because they're so far away. I don't want to have them walking all over the map. We've got silver here as well, which can be used in construction, but it's probably better to hold on to, because it's used as a currency. So we're going to make that not forbidden, or we're going to make it, yeah, unforbidden. And these scattered rocks here as well, they're used in construction. So pretty much everything that's around here, we're just going to allow them to pick up. Same with the wood. Right, we've got some batteries there I'd like to get to. Right, and there's one up here as well. So it's just making sure that everything, you know, that's nearby here, they'll be able to get access to. We're going to start the game in a moment. But first, we just need to set up a few things, just to make sure that everything's all good. This is our research terminal. That's where we're going to be researching from. And we pretty much need to start researching right away, as soon as we've mined into here. So I'm going to deconstruct that for now. So that means we'll be able to place it somewhere else. But now if we go to Architect and Orders, we can mine. So I'm just going to mine off this first little area here. And then we're going to start going into here. So I think it's actually stone there. So that's part of, well, we see that there's some stone tiles here as well. So there's definitely like this ancient civilization who was here at one point. Either that or just some very unlucky colonists. So we're going to mine into here as well. I think we might have to deconstruct that piece there. Yeah, I think we will need to. So what we need to do is hit claim on that first. And so that means that we kind of claim it as our own. From there, we're going to deconstruct it so we can tear it apart. Okay, from there, we're going to mine in a little bit further. I like doing two wide corridors just because with them being underground, quite often they can feel confined and there's a lot of negative mood factors that can come from it as well. When they're in that small space for too long, it can start to play hazard with their psyche. So we're just going to build out a bit of a space for them to live in at the start. That should be enough, and we're just going to chuck some beds in there. You know what? We might actually do that just first of all, because it might take them a little while to mine that all out. So we're just going to go under furniture and pick up sleeping spots. Now, it costs absolutely nothing to make these, because they're literally just a designated spot on the ground for them to sleep in. Okay, so we've got those set. We're looking pretty good. Now, overview is flashing, so I think it's a pretty good idea for us to go and have a look at that now. So if we pull that up here, go to manual priorities, we've got all of our colonists here, so we've got Nick, Logan, and Leon. What we're going to do is we're going to pull them up over here, and then we're going to start to designate what their kind of priorities are. So for Nick, we're going to make number one doctoring, so as soon as someone's hurt, he's going to jump straight to it. Now we're going to make number two construction. We're also going to make crafting number two for him as well. Actually, no, let's make that number three, because we do want him to craft, but if there's construction that needs to be done, he needs to be doing it, at least at the start anyway. But researching, we're going to make number one for him. So as soon as we chuck down the research terminal, he needs to do it straight away, because we just need to get that first bit of research done. Other than that, I think that's going to about do it for him at this stage. So we can have a look at them later on, and we can, you know, maybe get him doing some mining and some plant cutting. We're actually just going to chuck him a mining number one for now. Just so he can help out with the rest, because it's going to take a while for them to kind of get through everything there. Right, so I think that about does Nick for now. So let's go to the next one, which is going to be Logan. So we'll pull him up. Number one priority for him is wardening. So as soon as we capture someone, he's the sheriff. He's going to be taking care of them and also trying to bring them on board. Next, number one, is hunting. So as soon as we designate something for hunting, he's going to go out there and shoot it, bring it back. We're going to make number two for him cooking, because hunting comes before cooking. Then let's have a look. Let's see what else we got for him. We've got construction as well. So let's get construction, and we'll chuck that on two for now, because there won't be much cooking going on, so he should start doing that straight away. We're also going to need his help mining, so we're going to chuck that as a number one priority. And I think that's about going to do it for Logan for the moment. He's the only person cleaning. We're going to put everyone else on four at the moment, just so that if they're not doing anything, they'll be able to clean up. But I think that about does it. Yeah, so he's not very good at crafting at all, so we don't really want him crafting anything. Although, however, I have neglected his growing. So we do need him to grow things, so we're going to chuck him on two for growing and two for plant cutting. Now, let's see. I think that's going to do it for now, but we can always tweak these later on. I find I come back to them quite often and just start tweaking them when I find that people aren't doing exactly what I want them to. So now we're going to go to Leon. Let's see. Yep, there we go. Leon. Okay, so we're going to go to his overview. Now, construction is definitely his number one priority. Also, mining's going to be number one for him at the moment as well. We don't really want him doing any wardening. I mean, he's not good at it. So I don't even know if Nick should be. Well, he's got a 4 in social, so we'll let him do it for now. He's got a little bit of social skills from talking to Walter. Crafting is going to be quite high for Leon as well. He's a decent crafter, and he's got a passion for it as well, so he might actually be able to catch up to Nick sometime. So we're going to chuck him on a 3 for that for now, and he can also even research, so we're going to have that on 4, just because we don't need him researching at the moment. But we might actually get him researching later on. We'll see. We'll see how it goes. He's pretty terrible at medicine, but he can do it if we need, you know, if we need to. So I'm going to leave them off for the moment, but if Nick does get injured, we're going to chuck them on doctoring as well. But I think that's probably going to do it for Leon for the moment. Just having one last little quick look over everything. We probably will want him hauling eventually, but he's such a good miner that we're just going to want him mining at the start. Right, so that's the basic setup for us done. So that's going to get them running, you know, pretty well automated. So we're going to get the game rolling. So they're going to pick up their guns, and then they're going to start to get underway. So it's saying we need a stockpile. I'm going to let the mining happen for a little bit, but then we're going to do just a general stockpile out here, which is pretty much going to be where everything's kept. It's going to be a pretty lazy stockpile at the start. You can designate what you want to be in the stockpile up here. You can pretty much just chuck anything in there, or just have it designated just to, you know, take one thing. And then also priority as well means that, you know, which stockpile takes priority over another one. But for now, we're just going to have everything chucked in there. Although I was afraid of this happening. So Leon's our main miner, but Nick is doing the mining there. So we're just going to take control of him and tell him to go over there and get Leon to go in there and start that off. Okay, there we go. Now you can do other stuff, Nick. So you can hit draft any time and take direct control over the person. So that can be quite handy if they're, you know, doing something that you don't exactly want them to. Right, okay, so they're getting through there okay. Now, I didn't actually notice that this needed to be deconstructed as well. So we're just going to deconstruct that, although actually it hasn't been claimed. So we need to go back to orders, claim that as our own. Might as well claim that as well. And now we're going to deconstruct that. Great, so everyone's getting involved in this at the moment. This is the first kind of stage of them building their home. Now, it's just open. At the moment, we don't have any ability to make doors, which I know sounds crazy, but there really isn't much you can do at the start here at all. I can build rubble walls, and that's about it. Other than that, it's just graves. So we need to get that research terminal built in there as soon as possible. So we're going to go into MISC, and it should be there. There we go. We're just going to chuck it in the corner for now. And we're actually going to get Nick and tell him to prioritize hauling that, because he needs to start researching as soon as possible. Actually, looks like Leon's going to do that. That's okay, we'll let him do that. He would be faster at mining this area out, but, you know, hey, what can you do? So now that we're getting pretty close to having that all mined out, we're going to designate some other areas as well. So we're going to do the same thing over here. So I'm just going to come out like that and just go across. Let's see. Yeah, we're going to go straight out to there, and then we're actually just going to go outside and build a rubble wall for now. It's not the most secure thing in the world, but it's just going to have it even. Okay, so what we can do is deconstruct these beds for now and move them back inside. So it's something of a bonus for them. There we go. Okay, so now we're going to go under overview and take Nick off mining, so we're just going to put that on a, you know, another 2 priority. So if I take control of him, that'll stop him from doing that. And, oh, actually, I haven't designated research, that's why he's not doing it. So we go under research tab, and we've got RimWorld for Dummies. So that's the first thing under this tech tree minimi that we have to research. So that's going to give us trapper skills, metal synthesizing, well, the ability to research them. But this is going to give us some really basic survival tools, so we're just going to hit research. And then if we move Nick away from there, he's going to start doing it. Most tasks, you can prioritize them by right-clicking onto them, but for the research, you can't, just because it's an ongoing thing. Unfortunately, you can't prioritize it. But we see we've sealed that outside there a little bit. So they're going to be able to mine out the rest of this place, and then we'll be able to start building a few other things in here. So as soon as that research is done, we're going to be able to build a hand sawmill. And with that, we can get this wood that's over here and start chopping that into planks. And with planks, we can then build doors and a few other bits and pieces. But until we get that done, we're pretty limited to being able to do not a whole lot. We're almost done with our mining, so I'm going to place some more mining orders. Okay, that's good. So we've got the first piece of research done, so that's going to give us a few things that we can build. The main thing is this fireplace, wood pile, and grill. So that's going to be our main way to make food. We can also use, there's like a soup pot, cooking pot, yeah. So you can make soup out of potatoes and a few other things like that, but it keeps for like half a day. So you really can't make anything in bulk, and plus you have to have these rain barrels out and collect water, and it's a little bit overly complicated for something that doesn't last long at all. So we're probably going to go with the fireplace. So we're probably going to build this in this other room over here, going to make that kind of our cooking and dining room for now. So we're going to pull out here a little bit further, and I think we might actually build some individual bedrooms here. So we're just going to go in like that. Now, these are pretty luxurious bedrooms. They're pretty big. A lot bigger than I would usually do. But, you know, we've got a little bit of time here, and we've got space to expand. So I figure, you know, why not let them do it? So we're now going to go under production. We can also build a workstation as well. And we need a workstation to build make-do tools and a few other things that you need to build other workstations with. So we're going to build this outside for the time being. I think, let's see, we've got wood out here. We're just going to chuck it out here by the stockpile. Now that's pretty much going to be temporary. So now it needs make-do tools, and we've got three of them here. So we get those tools from disassembling those, drop pods. Yeah. So everyone's gone to sleep for now, so we're just going to fast forward through the night. Just let them sleep the night away. So they've survived their first day. That's good. We haven't had any crazy things happen. There are snakes in the jungle. I didn't realize that. I've got monkeys as well. So we'll be able to hunt those eventually. So this day, we're pretty much going to want to focus on trying to get the sawmill going. We've got a few stone blocks here, which is good. We can actually build some doors with those. So we're going to use those stone blocks and just build those doors now, just so it's safe. Leon's getting underway of making that, I believe. Yes, that's good. Okay, so now we're going to jump back over here to production. We're going to build this workstation as well. Now, I haven't quite decided exactly where I want everything to be yet, but this might be the workroom. Yeah, so we're going to chuck that there. That's also going to need some make-do tools. So we've still got some of those, which is good. Now this sawmill, we're going to add a bill. That's what you do to these stations. We're going to add some wood planks. I'm going to say do forever. So now, when someone's got free time, they're going to come over here and start sawing planks. Now, it's pretty slow because it's just a hand sawmill. You can get electric sawmills eventually, but that's still a decent way down the track. They're a little bit far off from getting to that point. We're going to let them keep on mining out those rooms there. Let them do their thing. We're going to have this workstation up in a moment as well, which is good. I think Leon's going to help out there. Yeah, we'll let them finish up that first. But we're also going to have a look now at the food utilities here. So we need a food preparation station, so that's quite a large one. We're going to let that go there. And a butchering table as well, which is also quite a large one. So we're going to chuck that just on the side here. So we've got these two things, which are going to sit about there. Now we might look at doing the fireplace over here as well. The only possible negative about the fireplace is that it actually is fire, and it can leap onto things, so I think that's far enough away that it's not going to cause any problems, but if it does, we're going to have to look at moving it. So as long as you have these things next to it, they'll work fine. So I think they just need metal and wood, so I think it's going to be okay for the time being. Yeah, no planks needed yet, apart from these stations here. So Leon, after he's built those, we'll get him to start trying to saw up some of those planks. We'll get as much done as we can in this day. The game's pretty friendly early on, quite forgiving. So the reason this door hasn't been built as well is that we've run out of stone. So we should try and get that before we leave that door open for too long. So to do that, we just go back over here to the orders. We're going to claim this wall here, and then we're going to deconstruct it. And it only takes some seconds, so it's a pretty efficient way to get stone early on in the game. We could do the same thing here as well in there if we need to. So we might look at doing that in the future. Cool. So Leon's going to come down here and do that. That's good. We don't actually need Nick researching for the moment, but we're going to chuck something down there. We're probably going to go for the stone cutting because walls, they help defend you. He's going to start doing that, but we don't need to research it right now. So we do need planks for that workstation as well, and we need the workstation to build things for these here as well. So it kind of all comes down to those planks. Let's see. He's going to start researching, but I'd rather he actually does the sawmill for the time being. So we're going to go to his overview, and we're just going to knock that back to, let's see. I'm going to put that on 2. Put mining on 3. And put researching on 3. There we go. So he's going to start sawing, and then once he's got enough planks, because construction's on 2, he's actually going to take those planks straight away and take them to the source, whichever one of these he needs to do. But after this is in place, we'll be looking pretty good. We'll have it sealed up. We can actually move 2 of these beds into separate rooms. Now we've actually got a pig inside. Okay, that's interesting. He's probably going to be locked inside, so I hope he's happy. Alright, so we just go back to furniture. And you know what? We should actually chuck these in the corners of the room. Except Logan's going to go to sleep before I can do that. Oh well. That's okay. The pig is hanging out super close to the fireplace. Right, just before we fast forward through the night, I'm just going to tell this woodpile here, by going to storage, to not take planks, because we don't want it to take planks. We only want wood logs to be there. Now, we've got a few logs still in place, but I'm just going to designate a few to be chopped down as well, just so we have a good source of wood for our fireplace. Wow, that boar is asking for it. So those have to be built before killing him is going to be any good for us. And for that, we're going to need more wood planks, and we need curtail tools. So we can build those here at the workstation. So we're kind of just hanging out for those planks. But that's probably going to be next time. Thanks for joining me. I really hope you've enjoyed the first episode. Let me know in the comment section what you think. If you like, if you dislike, if you think there could be any additions to it, just let me know how you're feeling. And until then, stay tuned.